this morning I want to do something a little different. And if your children would like to come up front, I'd like to invite them up front. If they're too shy and don't want to come up, totally fine. But if you want to come up, my daughter's ready. You can sit down. You can sit down all across the front, and we're going to talk to the kids. Anybody else want to come up? You're brave souls, Brian, sit down. All right, anybody else? Yeah, come on, man. Come on. Anybody else? All right. So what is today?
Mother's Day.
Not your day?
No.
Mother's Day. Mother's Day. Okay, Mother's Day. All right. And so I want you guys to watch this video, okay? And then I'm going to ask you some questions, okay? So you pay attention. Hold on, pay attention. Hey, boys, pay attention.
Stay up late playing cards on the Xbox.
JJ, What I love is a sister immediately after he says, my mom's name is Jenny also, she looks at me and she says, we live together. Who else? Who wants to say something else they love about their mom?
My mom's name is Tiffany. She keeps us safe.
That's awesome. Who else?
My mom's name is Amy, and she's always willing to help others when she can.
That's awesome. Right. Okay. Let's ask another question. I want quantity, okay? I want to know how much coffee do you think your mom drinks?
About 8 cups a day.
About 8 cups a day. That's also one of my daughters, Megan. She's telling the truth. She only drinks half a cup, because I find all the other cups that are half full around the house. What? How much coffee do you think your mom drinks, Evie?
She calls me the coffee girl.
Get my coffee.
Probably 20 cups.
20 cups living. That's ridiculous.
100.
100. They're just going up. They're saying who can say a bigger number. Elliot, listen. I'm your uncle. I'm not afraid to whoop you right now. Pay attention. He's debating whether I'm serious right now.
About 3 cups.
3 cups, hey, that's a reasonable answer. That's good.
5.
That's about my age. Yeah. Who else?
One or two.
Okay. She doesn't like coffee?
Half a day, and then she leaves the rest on the table.
Okay, yeah. Do you have one too?
Zero.
Jen doesn't drink coffee. Where is she? Wait, I mean, where is she? You don't drink coffee? What's wrong? How do you mother without coffee? Alright, what's another question? What is your mom's favorite thing to do? Let's get some kids to have an answer here. What is your mom's favorite thing?
Crochet,
alright. Anybody that has an answer? Henry? What's your mom's favorite thing to do?
She loves me.
Aww. Okay, you have an answer. What's your mom's favorite thing to do?
Does things.
What?
Does things?
Who else has an answer? What's your mom's favorite thing to do?
Teach us?
Teach you? I don't think so. What's your mom's favorite thing to do?
Make pies.
I like her.
Oh, yeah.
Who else has it?
Dale?
today. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Yeah, you already made their face at it. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment, with a promise, by the way, so that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on earth. Do you know that what the Bible is telling us is that if we honor our parents, if we obey our parents, what did he promise us that would happen? It says it may go well with you. In your years will be increased, you will live a long time. That's how much, how important God is telling us it is to obey, to honor, and respect your parents. So when it says, Henry, don't tell your brother in the middle of service, okay? Alright, so listen, when it says honor, what's that mean? I want to read something to you. It says to regard with great respect. How could you respect your mom today?
By cleaning your room when she says.
By cleaning your room when she says to do it.
Give her 45 minutes of a nap instead of 20.
45 minutes of a nap instead of 20. Is that okay with you? Alright, sold. 45 minutes. Well, I don't, let's not say shut up, but be quiet is a good one, yes. Be quiet is a good one, yes. Not be there for a day. Well, right, but how about obey, right, when mom says to do something? And what, when we say obey, because listen to what the Colossians 3:20 says. It says, children, obey your parents in everything for what it pleases the Lord. Isn't that awesome that when you obey your mama, it pleases the Lord. So what happens when we disobey our mom? It makes God sad. It says, the Bible says it pleases the Lord if we obey, which means the opposite is true. When we disobey, it makes him sad. And so honoring and respecting our mom, just put your hands down. And it says honor and respecting our moms. Right. It's talking about obeying, and it's talking about doing all the things we've been talking about, and it says it pleases the Lord. Isn't that awesome? That when you obey, it makes God happy. Isn't that really cool? It makes God happy when you obey. It also makes your mama happy. Alright? And so, kids, today I want you to very specifically think about what you can do today to do what those scriptures just told us. I want you to be thinking about, how do I honor and respect my mama today? Because sometimes, guess what? Maybe we don't have money to give presents. Maybe we don't have money to take her out, or we want to take her out for dinner or something like that. And that's okay. Something that really is awesome is when we follow the word of God and we make God happy when we obey him. And obedience is not just, okay, so if I tell Nora or Gretchen and say, Nora, Gretchen, I need you this, and the whole time they're doing it, they're saying, and they're just mad. That what God is finding out is when we obey and we have a good heart in doing it. And so obedience is more than just doing what she asks. Obedience is doing it with a good heart. Alright? And so it pleases God and makes him happy. Can we make our moms happy today by respecting them and honoring them? Three of you can? Well, I'm so proud of the three of you. How about the rest of you? Can we respect and love and honor our mama today?
Yes.
Yeah. And you know what? Turner said a hug. Can everybody here give their mom that present today?
Yep.
And really give her a really big hug? Not yet. Okay. I'll meet you later. Alright, so everybody today, I want you to listen, okay? I want you to really think about how you can honor and bless your mom by respecting her, okay? And in turn, it's going to make God so happy, alright? I want you to listen to this message, okay? I want you to listen to this video.
Who knows that the moms, on behalf of all the kids in the world, here are two things that the mom needs to know. Number one, put phone. Unless you can use Mary's phone.
Number two, don't name your kid phone.
It's just not right. That's messed up. Number three, we love you. It's just sometimes we don't know how to say it.
Sometimes it just comes out screaming or crying.
But the next time your kid screams, you know what they're really saying is, I love you, Mom. You're beautiful. Thank you for not naming me phone. Four, stop cleaning. Our house isn't messy. Our house is awesome. It's awesome because we live in it. My mom got stuck the boom. Number five, Mom, a timeout is wild. Doesn't really mean anything, but it's really cool. Wow. It should be like this. Wow, wow, wow. Number six, why are you here?
What an awesome responsibility that God believes you are worthy to carry as being a mother. You are impacting generations and generations and generations. Unbelievable what your job is. And we cannot thank you enough. As a husband, I always joke I can handle things, and then all of a sudden, I try to handle things and she's gone. I look at my wife sometimes and holding one of them on her hip and cooking and whatever else she's doing at the time, practicing worship with Mikey attached to her, you know, or hanging on her neck, or all the things that go through. And I'm just like, I can handle that for this amount of time. And I'm in amazement what you moms go through and the jobs that you do in raising our children. But I also wanted to say this. So many times I think this holiday is really attacked. And he wants those of you who might not be a mother yet or might not have had the opportunity to be a mother to say, well, this isn't for me. You're wrong. I want to share something with you that God has placed the heart of a mother in each one of you. And if you would grab a hold of that and you would go out and you would ask God and you would say, Lord, show me who I can be that mother figure to, that mother role to lead, to guide, to encourage, to love. You will have that same impact that every mom in this room that has actually had a baby has with theirs. You will have that impact. Don't let the world rob you of this day of saying, well, that's not me, or I'm gonna get depressed or this. For those of you that lost a mom, celebrate the time you've had with them. Go after God today. I want him to encourage you. I want him to bless you, rejuvenate you. And we want to thank you. The world does its best in saying that the job of a mom is second rate, and that's the biggest lie that this world could ever throw at you.
Yes, sir.
You are the glue to our families in so many ways, and we can't thank you enough. Kids, can we say thank you, Mom, all together on three? 1, 2, 3.
Thank you, Mom.
That was really, come on, we can do better than that. On three again. 1, 2, 3.
Thank you, Mom!
We're not going to do better than that, all right? I wanted to read this. I wanted to share this because I think what I said is there's a lot of lies that the world throws at some women on this day. And so my wife sent me this and thought it was very fitting. But I also wanted to throw this out there that some of you I know that are struggling because your children have maybe walked away from God. And I would just tell you and encourage you that the biggest rule you can have in your life right now is to never give up praying.
That's right.
Is go after God for their heart. Spend time on your knees in that godly anguish that we talked about, crying out to God for their salvation, for their life. And he will be heard. There is not a person in this room that has walked away from him that can't bring up someone in their life that never stopped praying. Be that person in their life. Spend time in the presence of God going after him. We're losing him. We're losing him. Hey, boys. Boys.
Henry.
Up there. It's always my family. Alright, so I just want to encourage you to never give up praying. So I want to read this. This Mother's Day, this is something that Megan sent me, like I said. To those who gave birth this year to their first child, we celebrate you. To those who lost a child this year, we mourn with you. To those who are in the trenches with little ones every day and wear the badge of food stains, we appreciate you. To those who experienced loss through miscarriage, failed adoptions, or running away, we mourn with you. To those who walk the hard path of infertility, fraught with pokes, prods, tears, and disappointment, we walk with you. Forgive us when we say foolish things. We don't mean to make this harder than it is. To those who are foster moms, mentor moms, spiritual moms, we need you. To those who have warm and close relationships with your children, we celebrate with you. To those who have disappointment, heartache, and distance with your children, we sit with you. To those who lost their mothers, we grieve with you. To those who have experienced abuse at the hands of your own mother, we acknowledge your experience. To those who live through driving tests, medical tests, and overall testing of motherhood, we are better for having you in our midst. We remember them and you on this day. For those who are single and long to be married and mothering your own children, we mourn that life has not turned out the way you longed for it to be yet. For those who step-parent, we walk with you on these complex paths. To those who envision lavishing love on grandchildren, yet that dream is not to be, we grieve with you. To those who will have emptier nests in the upcoming year, we grieve and rejoice with you. To those who place children up for adoption, we commend you for your selflessness and remember how you hold that child in your heart. And to those who are pregnant with new life, both expected and surprising, we anticipate with you. This Mother's Day, we walk with you. Mothering is not for the faint of heart, and we have real warriors in our midst. We remember all of you. Can I ask something? I want to do something today. I wanted to do a quick service because I believe the best way for us to go out and to honor our moms is to go and celebrate them, love on them, or whatever you're doing today, whether you're taking out tea or you're just giving them a break. I want you to do that today. I want you to go home. TC guys, you get that call. If you have a mom in your life, keep it about them. Honor them and respect them and love on them. Write a letter if you have to do that. Don't say it's not for me. What can you do today? And some of you, that's what I told you in that role of a mentor mom. Ask God what you can do in those relationships. And I just pray encouragement over each one of you. And I'm going to ask them, if all the moms in the room, if any of that, this fits that, would you stand up, please? Would you be brave enough to do that for me? Brian, again, sit down. Now, would you do me a favor, church? Would you just pray over someone around you? And I'm going to lead us in prayer. We're going to just pray a blessing over each one of these women in this room. Some of you are looking like shredders. You can put your, most of them, you know them. You can lay your hands on them. We can pray over them. All right? If they bite or hit, then take your hands off. Okay, that means no. All right? All right, let's pray. Father, we just worship you this morning. God, we are so thankful for each one of these women. God, we're so thankful for their hearts. We're so thankful for their lives. And God, I pray a special rejuvenation, a special gift of joy, a special gift of rest. God, I pray that over each one of them. God, I pray that you begin to speak to each one of their hearts, that you begin to give each one of them words from you, Lord. I pray that you begin to reach down and love on them, God. For the mothers that are represented in this room and the mothers that aren't represented in this room that are home, God, I pray that right now you begin to love on them. As you begin to wrap them in your arms to show them how much you love them, how much you desire to spend time with them, how much destiny and purpose you have in their life. And so, Father, I pray that you just show them, each one of them, that they are your daughter and that you love them so much. And so, God, I pray that blessing over them. I pray that you just begin to encourage them right now and speak to them and draw them in. In your name we pray all of this. Amen.